Now, we solve one problem from thermal stress. So, problem is a bar made of steel and aluminium which is rigidly fixed at both ends at A and C. Okay. An axial pull of 15,000 Newton is applied at point B. Okay. At 20 degree centigrade. Find the stresses on each bar if it is heated up to 80 degree centigrade. Thermal expansion of aluminium and steel both is given. Your modulus of steel and aluminium both is given. Okay. Now, as for the problem, this is steel bar. This diameter is less, so area is 1000 nanosquare, and that is for aluminium. So, cross section area is 1500 nanosquare. So length of the steel bar is given, length of the aluminium bar is also given. Okay. Now we have to find out the stresses on aluminium and steel. So as per the problem, your alpha S is equal to 11.8 into 10 to the power minus 6 per degree centigrade. Alpha A 24 into 10 to the power minus 6 per degree centigrade. Then ES is equal to 2.1 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per m square, and EA is equal to 0.7 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per m square. So initial temperature was 20 degree and the bar was heated up to final, that is 80 degree centigrade. Okay. Now there are initially, at a temperature of 20 degree, we have to find out stresses on steel and aluminium bar. And when temperature rises, temperature rise is 80 minus 20, that means 60 degree. When temperature rise 60 degree, that means temperature rise is 60 degrees, so at a temperature equal to 80 degree, we have to find out again the stresses. Then we will find out the net stress on steel and aluminium bar. Now, solution: at 20 degree centigrade. Now you can see, when the load is applied at point B on the steel bar, so steel bar will be under tension. Steel bar will be under tension, so it will elongate, and the aluminium will be under compression, isn't it? So due to that load, the steel bar will, length of the steel bar will increase and length of the aluminium bar will be decrease. Now, first of all, we have to find out the load which shared by the steel bar. Okay. Load by steel, suppose that is P1. So load shared by aluminium bar, that will be 15,000 minus P1. Okay. Now, as bar is equal to elongation of bar, that is equal to compression of, that means extension of steel bar is equal to contraction of aluminum bar. Elongation of steel bar of aluminum bar. So steel will elongate and copper will compress. So as per the formula, we know del L is equal to PL by AE. So del L we consider load share by steel P1 into LS by AS ES, that is equal to 15,000 minus P1 into L A divided by A into E A. Now P1 into L S is 100, area 1000 into ES 2.1 into 10 to the power of 5, that is equal to minus P1 into 120 divided by area 1500 into 0 point, that is from here 7 into 10 to the power 5. Now you see steel bar will be under tension and aluminum bar will be under compression. Now from that we can find the value of P1. So what is the value of P1? If you have calculated, you find out the value of P1. So value of P1 is 9379, that is in Newton, that is shear by steel, that Newton load is shear by steel. Now load shear by aluminium, that will be 15,000 minus 9379. So that value is 5620 newton. So LFPS is equal to 9379 and PA, that is equal to 5620 newton. Now stress on steel bar, that is equal to 9379 divided by area 1000. So that will be 9.39 newton per m square, and stress on aluminium, that is equal to 5620 divided by 500, that is equal to 3.74 newton per mm square. Okay. Now this stress in under tension, and this is compression. So Fs and Fa. Fs is equal to 9.39, that is tension, and compression is 3.74, that is compression. So it is at 20 degree temperature. Now temperature rise. Minus 20, that means 60 degree. Okay. Now we have to find out the stresses at 80 degree. Now you see, if the bar is free to move, so due to increasing temperature, due increase in the steel bar. Due increase in steel bar, if you leave it to expand, so there will be Ls alpha s into T, that is Ls is 100, alpha s 11.8 into 10 to the power minus 6 into T, that is 60 degree. Okay, so how much that value is 0.08 mm, and due increase of aluminium bar. Again, Na alpha A into T. So del Ls, that is 0.08 mm. That equal to Ln 120 into alpha A 24 into 10 to the power minus 6 into 60. That becomes 0.14 mm. So total due elongation of the bar, that is equal to 0.14 plus 0.08, that means 0.22 mm. Okay, so total elongation of the bar, but that bar is fixed. The bar is fixed while temperature increase 80 degree temperature, but the both end at Fc is fixed, so that elongation that will be prevented. Okay, that elongation will be prevented. So due to that, the forces on the steel bar is equal to the forces on the aluminium bar, that will be equal. So forces on steel bar, that is equal to on aluminium bar, that is due to the fixed at both end, and due to increase in temperature, due to increase in temperature and due to prevented to expand, that's why force on the steel bar and force on the aluminium bar both will be same. So if you consider Fs for stresses on steel bar, As that is equal to Fa, A, A.
So what will be Fs? Sorry, Fs. Force. Forces on the steel bar and forces on the aluminium bar. Forces of Fs, As, Fa, A, A. Fs, Fs into, Fs is equal to, so Fa into A by As. That means Fa into A is equal to A, that is 1500, then 1000. So it will be 1.5 Fa. So Fs is equal to 1.5 into Fa. So that is, then total elongation delta is equal to 0.22 mm. Now elongation prevented. Elongation prevented. If you leave it to elongate, so it will be extend how much? 0.22. That elongation was prevented. So we know the formula, del L is equal to PL by A. So elongation prevented, del L, that amount of elongation prevented. So we know the formula, Fs. PS, AS, PS, LS by PL by AS, ES plus PA, LA by AA, EA. So that is, you can write FS, LS by ES plus FA, LA by EA. So total elongation 5626 EA. So you put the value, Fs is equal to 1.5 Fa into LS is equal to 100 divided by 2.1 into 10 to the power 5 plus Fa is equal to Fa into LA is equal to 120 divided by EA is equal to 0.7 into 10 to the power 5. So from that we can find out Fa. That Fa is equal to 96.25 meter per mm square, that is under compression. That is under compression. Now what will be the Fs? Fs is equal to 1.5 into 96.25. So value is 144.38 Newton per mm square. That is also under compression. Why it is compression? Because the elongation was prevented, so it will be under compressive force. So steel and aluminium both will be under compressive stress. Now net stress on steel bar and on aluminium bar. So initially this was under tension. Tension, it was Fs fs was
9.37.
It was under tension.
Another was
3.74. That is under compression. So net stress on steel bar 144.38 under compression 9.37. So the value is
135
Newton per mm square, that is under compression. And net stress on copper bar, that is 96.25 plus, there is also compression 3.74. So that will be, value is 99.99 Newton per mm square, that is also under compression. So this is the value when the temperature rise. When the temperature rise on a system. Now if you see, if the question is revised, initial temperature 80 degree and final temperature 20 degree. In that case, you can see here, if temperature reduce, initially if temperature reduce, so both the bar will be under tension. If temperature reduce, what will happen? If temperature reduce, so it will try to compress, but as both in fixed, both the bar beam or bar will be under tension. So if question is revised, temperature is revised, then here you can see tension in compression portion, that will be changed. Okay. So this is the end of the problem.